home, where everyone is welcome. Poems and songs inspired by American immigrants. Poems by Deepak Chopra and Kabir Sehgal. Home is the place where when you go there, they have to take you in. Robert Frost. Perhaps home is not a place, but simply an irrevocable condition. James Baldwin. To meditate means to go home to yourself. Then you know how to take care of the things that are happening inside you, and you know how to take care of the things that happen around you. Thich Nhat Hanh. Introduction. We wrote these poems and songs to celebrate and cherish immigrants. After all, the United States is a country composed of and built by immigrants, and it has been a beacon to those in search of a new life for hundreds of years. It's written on the pedestal of the Statue of Liberty. Give me your tired, your poor, huddled masses yearning to breathe free, the wretched refuse of your teeming shore. Send these, the homeless, tempest-tossed to me. I lift my lamp beside the golden door. Now, more than in recent memory, that lamp is shining less bright and the door is closing. Too many of our friends and family members feel like strangers in their own home. Some 13% of Americans, or 41 million, are immigrants. And 20% of Americans have at least one parent who was born in another country. Without immigrants, our demographics would implode. There would be fewer workers to support the aging population, and economic growth would suffer. So, spurning immigrants and shunning those who are different is a troublesome and dangerous development in our beloved country. That someone feels uninvited, unwanted, and unwelcome in their home just because they are different or from somewhere else belies the founding principles of our country, which affords us the freedom of speech and belief. It's our hope that by hearing these poems and listening to these songs, you will be reminded about the value of immigrants and the importance of making our fellow friends, family members, neighbors, and citizens feel welcome and at home. We chose the title Home, Where Everyone is Welcome, for this very reason. Quite naturally, most identify home with a place, whether it's a one-room concrete edifice in Red Hook, Brooklyn, or a rustic residence in Redlin, Iowa. Home is the place where you live, separate from the outside world, where you can hopefully refresh, recharge, and rejuvenate. Just as a medicine cabinet may offer insight into your health or a shelf of books reveals your learning, a home is a window into your aesthetics, sensibilities, and even values and principles. It follows that if we also think of home as our city, state, and country, then what sort of place do we want it to be? At the same time, home isn't just a physical place. It's a sense of protection and security. It's a feeling of comfort and ease, familiarity and intimacy. Home is where you belong, where you have the liberty to think your thoughts, autonomy to express yourself, and freedom to be yourself. You get the sense of belonging in your own place, but you can also feel it when you're with dear friends, loving family, and genial neighbors. In this way, home may be less a product of your physical whereabouts, but a state of mind and creation of consciousness activated by the memory and the emotional centers of your brain. If you're at home in your thoughts and have peace of mind, you're in a better condition to radiate warmth, friendship, generosity, and empathy to others. By being at home, we help others feel at home. Indeed, home isn't just a feeling that we get, but give. We must relearn this lesson as Americans because immigration isn't just the topic du jour, but du generation. Every generation confronts the scourge of intolerance, which has been faced by many. Native Americans, African Americans, German Americans, Irish Americans, Italian Americans, Chinese Americans, Japanese Americans, Mexican Americans, Muslim Americans, and more. Such discrimination has been institutionalized. The Constitution prevented African Americans from gaining citizenship until the 14th Amendment in 1868, and women from exercising their citizenship by voting until the 19th Amendment in 1919. The Chinese Exclusion Act of 1882 prohibited Chinese from becoming citizens. The Immigration Act of 1917 established a literacy test and banned all immigrants from Asia. The Quota Act of 1921 favored immigrants from Northern European countries. Executive Order 13769 and Executive Order 13780 issued in 2017, but stymied by the courts, reduces the number of refugees who can enter the United States, and these orders impose a travel ban from those living in certain countries. These measures stoke anxiety and xenophobia, which creates a vicious cycle of doubt and distrust among Americans. This is America at its worst.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.